At the start of last week's podcast, we very briefly mentioned that a good friend of ours, good friend of the show, Micky Daly, had actually fallen ill. And this past week, we heard the terrible news that Micky had actually passed away. Now, ourselves in the Big Rab Show, obviously, were absolutely stunned about this news, but it seemed to be everyone in the piping world was equally so. And the outpouring of love, support and messages from all over the piping scene, not just locally here in Northern Ireland, it's just incredible, really. So I feel there's no other way that we could start this week's podcast without paying tribute to our friend, who will be sorely missed by everyone, Micky Daly. So, yeah, we reached out to a number of sources, of course. Micky has been part of many different pipe bands over the years, and we asked their pipe majors and band representatives and such to get in contact with us and just to share their thoughts. Now, that's not just to say there's been so much outpouring and, you know, even there's been online performances as well. Kyle High actually dedicated one of his marches that he's been doing each day to Micky. It was such tragic news. It really knocked everyone over. And our thoughts and sympathies really are with Shelly Ann and the Campbell family and the Daly family too. This will be an incredibly difficult time for them and for all of his friends at the moment. Just really quite tragic and terrible news to try and take in, which in the middle of what is already an incredibly difficult time with all of this global pandemic carrying on. So at this point in the show, we're going to dedicate some time. Instead of our usual kind of start where we talk about our Patreon and our website and all of that kind of stuff, and we get into listener mail and weekly drone and all of that kind of stuff, this week we're going to spend some time and we're going to dedicate the beginning of this week's podcast to our friend, Micky Daly. And to everyone else who reached out to us, here's their thoughts on the passing of Micky Daly.
I first met Micky when I answered a knock at my door. Standing there wearing a motorbike helmet, all he said was, "I'm here for Collie Backey's music." Typical Micky, straight to the point. He was a reliable, trustworthy, and more than able band member. The piping world now has a gap that may never be filled. From Andy McGregor.
Columkill Pipe Band done a recruitment drive in the local secondary school. Michael and about four or five of his friends joined. Michael lived five doors away from where we, the Hassans, lived. Michael and my son Mark both learned at the same time. Both were extremely easily taught, with their first tune being the tricky, itchy fingers. I never to this day have come across two boys who were that easily taught. Michael very quickly became an extended member of the family. And when we were not practicing on the chanters, Micky and the boys played football. And when we went shopping, so did Micky. I have always been proud that Michael was taught well enough that he could go on to other bands and play up the grades. What makes me even prouder was that Micky never forgot where he came from and who taught him, remaining a close family friend and a friend of Columkill, always. The Hassan family and I and the Columkill Pipe Band were deeply saddened and rocked to the core when we heard the devastating news of Micky's sudden illness and passing. We send our thoughts, prayers and condolences to Shelly Ann, the Campbell and Daly families at this difficult time. A young gentleman ticking too soon. Rest in peace, Micky. From Brian Hassan Sr.
Although Micky only competed with the Quinn for a year, he immediately fitted into the band and he became part of the extended Quinn family. He was a very dedicated and a very loyal member, not to mention a very talented piper. Although he played with various higher grade bands, he never would have belittled our players and he never would have questioned my leadership. And that's a quality that not many have, and it didn't go unnoticed. In fact, Micky would have encouraged the players to reach their full potential with his kind words, calming manner, and he was a real asset to the band. His love and dedication to piping was only second to his love and dedication to Shelley Ann, and this was clearly evident to anyone who knew them. His loyalty also extended to Shelley Ann's family too, as he spent many days and many weekends away with Martin and Jennine. Micky had a huge personality, he was always up for a bit of fun and crack, and he and Shelley Ann certainly lived life to the full. Shelley Ann, Martin and the family have all lost a huge part of their lives. Although their pain may fade through time, their memories of the special moments never will. I would like to take this opportunity on behalf of the extended Quinn family to express our deepest sympathy to Shelley Ann, to Martin, and all the Campbell and Daly families, and trust that they will find comfort in the knowledge that Micky made a huge impact on so many people who count themselves privileged to call him their friend. As someone once said, those who knew him will miss him, and those who didn't have missed out.
Hi Rob, David Chesney here. All the band at Gluskelt are really shocked and saddened to hear what has happened to Micky. He joined the band last year and was really looking forward to the season starting. Unfortunately, obviously, COVID came about and it was cancelled. But he was a great character, he had great attitude, and we're really sorry we never got to compete with him. Our deepest sympathy goes to Shelley Ann and his family circle at this time. Thank you, Nate.
Micky, I never thought I'd have to write this, but it was a pleasure to be able to play alongside you and have you as a mentor. Natalie and I always looked up to you, quite literally. But no matter what, you'll always be an amazing friend to us. Our sincere condolences go out to Shelley Ann and both the Campbell and Daly families at this difficult time. Have a party up there, big man, and we'll see you on the counter march. Rest in peace, my friend. Davy Moyes and Natalie Meldrum.
Micky Daly. Although only in the band for a short time, Micky was a very popular and likeable character who still kept in touch with its members after the band had finished competing. He was a great piper who turned up knowing all the tunes and just got on with the job with no fuss. On behalf of all the Vale of Athol Grade 1 members, Micky will be sadly missed and the band are very grateful for the time we had together with him. Sincere condolences to Shelley Ann and all Micky's family and friends. Vale of Athol, Grade 1 Pipe Major, Adrian Cram.
I just want to say we are absolutely gutted at the loss of Micky. He was a tremendous personality, he was a terrific piper and a great friend. And all of our love goes out to Shelley, his family and his band. We know that he's smiling down on us with a pint in his hand. And anytime it rains on a band at the Worlds, we'll assume that's him relieving himself of said pint. So Micky, Solancha brother, love, Josh and Andy, Chanaran Podcast.
Thiepval Memorial Pipe Band is shocked and saddened to learn of the sudden passing of our former piper, Micky Daly. Micky joined our band at the beginning of 2014. And it's no coincidence that this was one of the band's most successful years, culminating in the World Championships. Micky was a talented Grade 1 piper, and from his experience, helped to raise the standard of other pipers in the band. Micky's larger-than-life character meant he was popular with the members and supporters of the band, both young and old. The band wished to extend their heartfelt sympathies to Shelley Ann Campbell and all of the Campbell and Daly families. Our thoughts also go out to all of Micky's friends, of which there were many.
I have to say a huge thank you to all of our contributors. We do know that that would not have been easy to share your thoughts and feelings like that, honestly, at such a tragic time. Again, I have to repeat myself, but from ourselves here on the Big Rab Show, we can say that Micky will be very sorely missed. He was a good friend of the show, never missed a podcast, and was quite happy to add his commentary every now and again and chip in with words of wisdom when we were getting things wrong. So Micky will be very sorely missed by ourselves in the Big Rab Show. We have to say our sincere condolences to Shelley Ann, and of course to the Campbell family and the Daly family as well. And yeah, just to pass on our thoughts and just to let you know that we're all here for you. And yeah, Micky will be very sorely missed. So guys, this has had a huge impact in the piping scene here in the UK and also here locally in Northern Ireland specifically. And so I do know that a lot of you folks tuning in internationally may not be aware of who Micky was and his impact on the piping scene, but I do hope that this kind of gives a little bit of the gravity of the kind of the amazing person that he was. He was certainly a big personality, and he was considerably taller than I was, and always just to love making fun of me. I thought you were a big Rab, sure you're the only height of two turf. So... yeah, I think at this point, after we've dedicated the beginning of this week's podcast, we should really take a break at this point. But yeah, I think I can't go any further without playing one of Micky's proudest moments, actually, was being a part of the Vale of Athol Pipe Band. In 2018, he competed with the band at the Worlds and, yeah, had the honour of walking into the circle with them and, yeah, competing with the band. And he did say that it was one of his... you know, highest achievements, I suppose, is competing at the Worlds in Grade 1 with the Vale and playing some blistering tunes. So, yeah, at this point, we'll play a little excerpt, I suppose, of Micky's performance with the Vale of Athol back in 2018. And then we'll get into the rest of the show. So here they are. Here's the Vale of Athol Pipe Band, a little excerpt from their 2018 World Championship performance.